We are joined here today by Dr. Ryan Neuhoffel. He is known as Dr. New in our community, and we're pleased to have him with us on lawrencehits.com. Recent story came out, and you've probably been hearing about Zika virus. And, of course, the Olympics are going to be held in Rio later this summer. Some athletes are already skipping the games because of the risks of Zika virus. We've heard of some folks coming down with that. So Dr. New is going to try to help us clear that up. But Dr. New, as we get started, even though we've been hearing about Zika virus maybe in tropical places or places far away, there was a recent story in one of the media outlets that said that Douglas County was one of the highest risk areas for Zika virus in the United States.
Yeah, well, this is a pretty complex topic. The mosquito species that carries the Zika virus is something that has been for a long time found in this area. It's way more common in tropical regions. The virus itself has not been found in Kansas, to my knowledge, at least in the mosquitoes. There have been some Kansans who've contracted it upon travels. Coming back, they got sick and found out that they had contracted it elsewhere. So it is a theoretical risk that the mosquitoes that carry the virus, because they're present here, eventually will get the Zika virus in them, and then theoretically they could bite people. But as of right now, most of the places in the U.S., except for maybe some of the southern parts, you know, Florida and Texas, are probably pretty low risk for significant amounts of the virus being contracted there.
One virus we've been hearing about for several years now, Dr. New, is West Nile. Mm-hmm. And we know we've had several cases in Kansas and elsewhere of West Nile. It's been going on maybe 15, 20 years. Mm-hmm. So how does Zika compare to West Nile? Yeah. Obviously, we know we've had widespread cases of West Nile, or at least more cases. But could Zika someday reach those levels?
Well, you know, it's interesting. That's a great corollary, actually, because West Nile virus is a virus. It says it right there. And so is Zika. They're both mosquito-borne illnesses. And there's lots of other examples. I would say the initial concern about West Nile is somewhat similar to what is happening now with Zika. I was a public health student, actually, when West Nile, everyone was frightened of it. And, we know that these viruses can act on people in various ways. And West Nile has really proven to us that West Nile is actually quite common in Kansas, but the vast majority of people who contract it get a very mild, if no symptoms at all. And so the big difference between West Nile virus and Zika virus is Zika is associated, we now are fairly confident, with birth defects. And so pregnant women who contract Zika, there's a fair amount of risk of something called microcephaly, that's a growth defect in the growing fetus. So I would say in some ways they actually share. So even if you contract the Zika virus, if you're healthy adults and you're not pregnant, the risks of getting really, really sick are very low, much like we have seen with West Nile. You know, 10 years ago, everyone was freaking out about West Nile, and now we know that probably 70% of people don't even see the doctor and don't even know they're sick.
Well, we are in the summertime now, Dr. New, so obviously mosquitoes are going to be out there at night. There's some precautions that people can take. I know one thing people don't like to do, especially when it's 95 degrees with 80% humidity, is wear long sleeves and long pants when they go out in the evening.
Yeah, I would be among one of those people. Yeah, and with mosquito-borne illnesses, really, truly the best strategy to limit this problem is to not get bit by mosquitoes. There's a lot of different prevention strategies. Probably the most proven ones are the clothing that you wear, and then insect repellents. DEET and several other over-the-counter products are effective at reducing the number of bites you get. And if we reduce the number of bites that we get, the less likely you are to actually contract something. So like many viral illnesses, we don't have great treatments for them. So if you do contract West Nile or Zika virus or a host of other viral illnesses, we don't have great medical treatments. Like an antibiotic for them will not work. The best strategy is to limit the number of mosquito bites that you get.
And finally, is of course, there's always places where puddles can certainly become large. You want to get rid of those because that's where the mosquitoes pretty much increase their population.
Yeah, absolutely. So what's really interesting here is that the type of mosquito that carries Zika virus, which I'll try to butcher if I say the name of it, is not probably as associated with standard water issues as the normal mosquitoes. But yeah, generally speaking, that limiting the amount of mosquitoes that are being bred, especially near houses, so making sure that your bowls and anything that would collect water is emptied out frequently is very important.
Dr. New with us on lawrencehits.com, letting us know about the Zika virus.